Good morning, one and all. Myself Shukant. I am Assistant Professor of Sedmart Engineering College. Today I would like to discuss about DA. So, actually, what is DA? DA is nothing but design analysis algorithm. DA is nothing but design analysis algorithm. Actually, why we are using this DA? What was the importance of this DA? So, DA comes under complete algorithms. Okay, when we are going to discuss about many algorithms. So most important algorithms are in DA itself. Okay, in algorithms are coming. Actually, what was the definition of DA? DA is nothing but design analysis algorithm. So actually, what were the definitions? DA is a step by step procedure which contains set of instructions and to be executed in a certain order to get the desired output. Okay, DA is nothing but step by step process, set of instructions to be executed in a certain order. Okay, so actually in DA we have some techniques. Okay, what are the techniques? Sorting techniques, searching techniques, and also insertion techniques, and also updation techniques, and also division techniques. These are all are concerned with the particular DA. Okay, these are all concerned with the algorithms of searching, sorting. Okay, searching is an algorithm. Okay, and sorting it is also one type of algorithm. And updation, it is also one type of algorithm. And insertion, it is also one type of algorithm. And deletion, this is also one type of algorithm. These are the algorithms we are discussing in our real time problems. Okay, these are all algorithms are working in the real time problem. So searching algorithm, like here is the searching algorithm. Suppose if you take an array list of data, suppose there is 100 elements. If you want to find a particular number, suppose if you want to find star, suppose the array contains 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. Suppose in this array, if you want to find a particular element, so how we will find by using the key operation. Okay, key operation nothing but k value. Okay, suppose I want to find the 60. So this is my key value. So what I have to do? I want to compare with 10, first 10, again I am going with the second 10 with 20. So like this we are comparing up to particular element. Okay, when I find the particular element, then only the key is matching. So this is in this process it is taking more iterations. Okay, in this process it is taking more iterations. So we have iteration process of binary and linear. So we have binary iteration, at the same time we are having the linear iteration. Okay, coming to sorting algorithm, if you want to sort the order ascending or descending or alphabetical, so we are using this as sorting algorithm. And also we are using the updation algorithm. By here is the updation algorithm. Suppose if you want to update username or password or any kind of data, we are going for the updation algorithm. So insertion algorithm is nothing but suppose if you want to insert any type of data, we are going with insertion algorithm. So deletion already we know. To delete the particular item in the list, we are going for the deletion algorithm. So these are all algorithms we are coming in the DA itself, design analysis algorithm. Before first we have to what we have to do, we have to design. Okay, we have to analysis. Afterwards we have to design. After the designing we have to what we have to write our algorithm. So algorithm we can write in languages. Okay, algorithm we can write in n languages. So n languages is nothing but suppose I can say here we have some algorithm here. So single algorithm we can write in n languages, nothing but number of languages. Okay, suppose what I told, it is a step by step process. Okay, set of instructions. Okay, first step by step process. Suppose step 1. What is step 1? It is a start. Okay, step 1 is nothing but how to start. What is step 2? Step 2 is nothing but suppose I want to actually here the what was the problem actually what was the problem. So adding up two numbers. Okay, I am writing one problem, that is adding up two numbers, that is a plus b. Suppose adding up two numbers, that is a plus b. So I want to write algorithm this for number n languages, nothing but number of languages. So first I am what I am doing, I am declaring the variables like int a, b, c. okay. Then I'm going for the step 3 next. I'm declaring the variables, right? So here I'm defining the values for A comma B. Okay. Step four. What we are doing? We are adding the values. Okay. Step four. We are adding the values. A and B. Okay. A plus B. Okay. We can write. Step five. What have to do after adding the values? What have to do? We have to store in the C itself. So I'm storing the value in. C. So like this we can what was the step? We have to print the C. Okay, we have to print the particular C. So step 7 what was? So we started and we ended, stop. Okay, in this way we are writing the one algorithm. Suppose for this same algorithm we can write it in another manner also. Okay, we can write in another manner. Suppose directly step 1 start, step 2 add define values A, B, C. Step 3 add values, so step 4 print C. Step 5 stop. So in this way, any number of languages, not only one language, we can write any number of languages as per our comfort. We can write the algorithm. We have to design, we have to analysis, we have to write the algorithm. Okay, so we make design, analysis, and write the algorithm. So actually, the most important topic is performance analysis. Okay, performance analysis. What is performance analysis? Performance analysis is nothing but, so the algorithm is efficient and fast. How we can say the algorithm is efficient and fast? How we will say? But based on the comparison. Okay, based on the comparison only we will say the algorithm is efficient and fast. So coming to performance analysis, there are two techniques. Okay, coming to performance analysis, there is a two techniques. One is space complexity. And also time complexity. Okay, there are two important techniques. One is space complexity, another one is time complexity. In space complexity, what is the meaning of space complexity? Suppose an algorithm, how much space is taking? Okay, an algorithm is how much space is required? Okay, that is mentioned as the space complexity. Coming to time complexity, so how much time is taken for algorithm to execute of the program? That is called as a time complexity. So here also space complexity also divided into some techniques, and also time complexity also we are dividing some techniques. Okay, so these are the two important things in the performance analysis. So after performing these two things, we will say that it is algorithm is efficient and fast. Okay, by comparison of this space complexity and also time complexity, we will say that the algorithm is efficient and fast. Okay, so space complexity also we have some techniques, okay, and also we have the time complexity also we have some techniques like linear space complexity, and also like we have